the News 8 Storm Team Forecast with meteorologist Matt Moore.
It's a frosty start to our Saturday morning across the Susquehanna Valley. In fact, we have freeze warnings that are up until 9 o'clock this morning, and temperatures widespread across the region are below freezing in a lot of places. We're looking live in Harrisburg right now. Clear skies, one of our cooler spots in the Susquehanna Valley right now, and right around the freezing mark here in Harrisburg, the capital city, 32 degrees. The relative humidity at 88%, so there's still a little bit of moisture in the air, enough that you'll probably have to do a little bit of scraping on your windshield for your vehicles this morning. A little bit of a light breeze here northeast around 3 miles per hour in Harrisburg, but generally calm winds, clear skies is adding up to be a cool night, or a cool morning, I should say. Right now, temperatures across the Susquehanna Valley in the 20s up towards Lebanon and Selins Grove, 28 degrees, 31 in Lancaster below freezing. We are at freezing, though, in Harrisburg, like I showed you, 32 in Carlisle, 32 in Lewistown. Our warmer spots are farther south. Around York, we're at 38 degrees, Gettysburg at 36 this morning, but still a widespread, pretty much a hard freeze across the region, and that marks the end of the growing season across our region. So for today, we'll start off on the chilly side of things, warming on up into the middle 50s in the storm team forecast. And hey, we're going to be seeing the sunshine pretty much all day today. But I think as we go into this afternoon, by this evening, we'll see those clouds start to roll on in ahead of our next cold front. Cool and breezy out ahead of that front, winds around 20 miles per hour, could be gusting even higher than that. And by tonight, the front moves through, so mostly cloudy early on. Clearing later, though, we'll see that front in and out of here very quickly, and we're not expecting any rainfall from it. A pretty dry frontal passage, and not as cold tonight because of the cloud cover. We'll see those lows in the upper 30s to near 40 degrees, which is closer to seasonal than what we've been seeing the past couple of mornings. Into tomorrow, another day in the mid-50s, clouds and sunshine in the wake of that cold front, but it will still be cool and breezy. The winds 10 to 15 miles per hour coming out of the northwest and making things feel pretty chilly. So, of course, it's Saturday. We're talking about Penn State football, and it's a big game tonight, taking on Ohio State, ranked fourth in the nation. In Ohio State tonight, around 8 p.m. for the kickoff, partly cloudy skies. It will be a chilly one for those players, 48 to 40 degrees for those game-time temperatures. In fact, some of you may actually be going to that game. It's within driving distance. You'll probably be leaving this morning, and it will be starting off with clear skies across the region. A few clouds, though, across the northern part of the state with that approaching cold front. The clouds are going to take a while to get here. In fact, probably by this evening, we'll start to see those clouds with that cold front that's on its way in. Otherwise, chilly temperatures, high pressure just off to our south and west. That will slide to the south and allow this cold front to move on in. This afternoon, breezy conditions out ahead of this front. The clouds start to move in. I've stopped it here right around 8 p.m., so yeah, a little bit of cloudiness making its way through, but you can see on Predictor, it's relatively dry as the front clears through by tomorrow morning. And then as we head through the day tomorrow, mostly sunny skies, or at least a mixture of clouds and sunshine. Into Monday, that high pressure basically moves right overhead, and that's going to continue all the way through the day Monday with the chance of maybe some clouds as we go late Monday into Tuesday. But after that, we're watching the next storm system that will arrive as we go into the middle part of the week. Temperatures moderating into the mid-60s, so a little bit more comfortable, but you're seeing the chance of showers there for Halloween. Of course, a lot of people watching that forecast for the trick-or-treating. It looks like the best chance of rain will actually be on Friday. Chance of a shower, at least right now, looks like very slight on Thursday.
I've got a knight and a princess, and an umbrella does not go with either one of those.
I agree with that. Let's hope the rain stays off to Friday.
All right. Thanks, Matt. Mm-hmm.